to the sky. Never let adventures pass you by. Be free and follow your crazy dreams. We're living our vision in the RV. Come ride with us and you'll be free.
So we're up in Somerville, South Carolina, just on the northwest edge of Charleston. We stayed across the street at a Cracker Barrel last night that does not have any RV spots, but we called there and they said it was fine to come and stay, just don't park in the back. The backside of the building has a small area and they had deliveries coming. There's no RV slots there, but they had a big parking lot in the front and on the side. But the area is a very nice area, so we felt pretty safe. And now this afternoon here, I came over to the Walmart to get some air put in the tires. They were down just a little bit. We're gonna go downtown and explore some of Charleston.
Charleston was founded in 1670 as Charlestown, honoring King Charles II at Albemarle Point on the west bank of the Ashley River that is now Charlestown Landing, but relocated in 1670 to its present site, which became the fifth largest city in North America within 10 years.
Say you cannot leave Charleston without seeing this picturesque, what is it, a seawall along the city's southern tip. Up there's a house truck. Ice cream.
Sadly, Charleston's significance in American history is tied to its role as a major slave trading port. Nearly one half of slaves imported to the United States arrived in Charleston. In 2018, the city of Charleston formally apologized for its role in the American slave trade.
Coming? Where'd you go? Can you tell? It's a beautiful area down here.
It is. Look at some of these homes.
The Battery is a landmark defensive seawall and promenade in Charleston, South Carolina. Named for a Civil War coastal defense artillery battery at the site, it stretches along the lower shores of the Charleston Peninsula, bordered by the Ashley and Cooper Rivers, which meet here to form Charleston Harbor. In the 18th century, rocks and heavy materials were used to fortify the shores of the Cooper River on the eastern side of the peninsula. In 1838, this area along the seawall became a promenade. First used as a public park in 1837, the area now known as White Point Garden became a place for artillery during the American Civil War. In 2004, a structural report by the city of Charleston showed that the battery was suffering serious problems and could fail to protect the southeastern portion of the city during hurricanes. In 2012, the city announced that a $3.2 million restoration project would soon commence at the juncture of High Battery along East Battery and Low Battery along Murray Boulevard.
Pretty.
It is very
Michelle decided she wanted to change before we walked any further. What a great place than going back home and change in your own bathroom and getting the clothes out of your own closet.
I'm only getting my jacket.
I thought you said you were changing your shorts too or something.
My shoes.
Okay, shoot. Well, see, your shoes, you wouldn't normally be carrying another pair of shoes with you. So. What is it that you like about these areas like this?
Well, I'm a history buff, so I like, you know, everything old, pretty much.
So you like me?
Yeah.
Robert Smalls is known as the slave that sailed himself to freedom just before dawn on May 13, 1862. Robert Smalls and a crew composed of fellow slaves in the absence of the white captain and his two mates slipped a cotton steamer off the dock, picked up family members at a rendezvous point, then slowly navigated their way through the harbor. Smalls, doubling as the captain, even the captain's wide-brimmed straw hat to hide his face, responded with the proper coded signals at two Confederate checkpoints, including at Fort Sumter itself and other defense positions. Once outside of Confederate waters, he had his crew raise a white flag and surrendered his ship to the blockading Union fleet. In fewer than 4 hours, Robert Smalls had done something unimaginable. In the midst of the Civil War, this black male slave had commandeered a heavily armed Confederate ship and delivered its 17 black passengers, 9 men, 5 women, and 3 children, from slavery to freedom.
I said, tell me your story. Something for me. Then he kept walking on down the road, and I watched him disappear like smoke. And I thought I'd just seen a ghost. Then I looked down at what he wrote.
One of these things doesn't belong.
This is Rainbow Row. The name Rainbow Row was coined after the pastel colors they were painted as they were restored in the 1930s and 1940s. It is a popular tourist attraction and is one of the most photographed parts of Charleston.
Very fragranty.
Thank you.
lavender waffle cone.
A lavender waffle cone. We haven't had ice cream or gelato for a long time, so we're sharing a really small one.
There's a little baby spoon.
I like having your own bathroom with you everywhere we go.
It's very handy.
So this Walmart has a Sam's Club over here too. We had a fifth wheel and a travel trailer staying here last night. Looks like there's a Class A over there still. We're parked here right at the end of the lot. An outlet right here next to us. A lot of shopping, so there's a lot of activity, so it seems pretty safe. Where are you at? She's out there. I went out to put some bug spray on, a little insect repellent, and because the no-see-ums are horrible here in Charleston. They're just horrible. We found a place to park finally. This place is absolutely crazy. We found this big lot here, and they happen to have one big spot right here. Little meter over here. Do you pay for parking?
Okay.
Ready?
Where are we going?
This way.
This is the way.
This is the way. There's another lot over here, but you had to be eating at the restaurant tonight in order to park there. And we already ate, so we parked here.
Although I wouldn't be opposed for a dessert. I really, really want to come back sometime because there's so much to see, and I want to see a plantation or two, so someday. Hey, it says free praline samples.
Oh, for the love. She's in heaven every time we go to the shopping place. She's like, that'll be me at the beach if I keep going the rate I'm going. Then I'll be having my last supper. Cookies. In action. My goodness, how far does this go? Two buildings that way, and I don't know how many more buildings this way. by Peninsula Grill. Benny's by Peninsula Grill. It was a neat little place. Very, very nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Kind of high-end dessert place.
Right, yeah. After dinner drinks,
but,
kind of thing.
Yeah. The gluten-free cake. It wasn't the greatest at all. I'm not going to lie. That was dry. Very dry. Cream cheese was great.
The coconut cake, I probably rated about an 8.
Carrot cake was about a 3. Trying to drive. I had to drive down this narrow road. And where's my keys? Oh, here they are. So we had some, met up with a few trucks also, but we managed to get by. So just an FYI, you don't want to take a big RV down through here. Something as wide as this fan is just fine. But it's pretty narrow. We drove by the tree when we were on our way down here. This thing is massive.
It's just crazy that it survives this long and the way it grew.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable.
How many years old is it?
I think I saw online it was maybe almost 5. They think 500 to 600 years old.
Jeez. Oh my gosh.
So cool.
That is just remarkable. I'm sure it looks a lot different in person than it does on camera. Another Sprinter van. Massive, isn't it?
It is.
next stop, Angel Oak Restaurant. And then we're leaving Charleston. A little over a 5-hour drive after we eat.
This was a good stop, though. I mean,
it was. I'm glad we decided to do this. Was it last night or this morning? Well, we were still trying to debate this morning, weren't we?
But, it wasn't really raining yet because I did read a sign that said if it rains or thunderstorms, they close it anyway. So we lucked out there.
Yeah.
And the fact that it's going to be closed tomorrow because of Easter. So good thing we were still here in the area today, not leaving. And so anyway, worked out.
It worked out. The only thing we got to look at is where we have to be in a week from now.
Yes.
And how much we want to get done in the meantime. Well, we wanted to go to our next destination today, ASAP, first thing this morning, get driving. But, however, since it was going to be raining and storming there, and the place we wanted to go was outside, we thought, well, there's no use of hurrying going there. Since it's not raining here yet, which it did kind of start, but it's not pouring down like it is at our next destination. And we decided to go ahead and enjoy seeing something else here that we were wanting to see, because there's so much to see in this area.
Oh, goodness, yeah.
But, so we just decided to go see this tree and something quick to stop and look at, and the restaurant's just about 7.5 miles away from here. And then that'll put us out a little bit later to our next destination when the rain is supposed to be pretty much finished. So that's why we did that. Don't message us and say, why didn't you do this? Why didn't you do that? Because we're just not going to answer. No.
We do what we do.
Yeah, we do what we do. Just watch. There's some parking back behind the restaurant here. There's a little lounge right here, their cocktail lounge. But it shows they don't open till 4 p.m., so they're closed right now, so we can park right in front of the doorway here. Oh, man. Miserable weather. This food is supposed to be amazing. We're about to find out. Got your little umbrella,
I brought it,
Mary
this time,
Poppins?
Because it's already starting to rain.
It's a good idea, Mary Poppins.
Who are you?
Ow.
Chim Chimney Cherie.
Chim Chimney, Chim Chimney. No gluten-free bun. Oh my gosh, shrimp and grits.
Shrimp and grits and fried green tomatoes.
Beignets. Well, that was very, very, very
good.
Good.
We recommend, highly recommend this restaurant.
It's a very good restaurant. So if you come and see the Angel Oak tree, make sure you come and eat at Angel Oak Restaurant, because it was very, very good food. And this was just lunch.
Yeah, and this was like, what, was it about 10, 15 minutes from the tree? I mean, it's not near the tree at all.
Yeah, 7 miles, 7.5 miles.
Yeah.
But,
very good. Oh my gosh.
Even like, though, she had the beignets, those desserts.
The lightest I have ever tasted. They melted in my mouth. They were so good.
I think we get the point.
Yeah, they were good.
Are you going to get in?
Okay.
Funny girl. Funny girl she is, but a sweet. Y'all ready for a long ride? We're not. Sure we are. Only been doing it for a little over 4 years now. Almost 4.5.
Mm-hmm.
Shall we go?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go. I was gonna give you a bump, but yeah. Just, I don't know, I kind of decided not to. Ready? Okay.
Yeah.
Celebrate. Let's celebrate.
forget to subscribe to our channel, click that little bell, and hit that thumbs up. See you next week.